In this video, you will learn how to create a reference plane, that is, an additional plane on which we will be able to create a sketch. By default, we can create sketches on the basic planes of the coordinate system and on the faces of a solid, but as in this case, I would like to create a sketch on a plane passing through the center of this solid. So first I need to create a construction plane. And this video is a continuation of Fusion 360 Beginner's Guide, and the link to the previous parts is in the description of this video. And on the construction plane, I want to create a sketch to make a solid by rotating a sketch. And before we do that, I will create a new project and show you how the operation of creating a 3D solid by rotating a 2D sketch works. I will create a new sketch on XZ plane. This is a half section of an axis symmetric solid, and now to create solid based on this sketch by rotating the sketch, let's select Revolve command. The profile has been selected by default, but if you otherwise have several geometries or the geometry is incorrectly selected, click this button to deselect the selection, and now the profile selection is active. And left click on the profile on the basis of which we want to create a solid by rotating the sketch. Then activate the selecting of the rotation axis by left clicking on this button and select the axis or line relative to which the sketch is to be rotated. Select this line. Then it is worth paying attention to the angle parameter, and by default is 360 degrees, so we will get a full solid. You can enter a different value here, and you will get a solid made by rotating the sketch by a specific angle. Okay, click OK to confirm, and this way we can create 3D solids by rotating a 2D sketch. Now I would like to create another fragment of this solid in such a way that I will create a sketch in the middle of this solid. And based on this sketch, I will create a solid by rotating the sketch. And for this, I need a construction plane that will pass through the center of the solid. And to create a reference plane, select one of the available options for creating construction planes. And in this case, select midplane. Then select this model face and this face. And the reference plane is created between these faces. Click OK to confirm, and now to create a sketch on this plane, select this plane and select Create Sketch. Then draw any circle. OK, escape to cancel this command, and now I would like the center of the circle lies on this line, and to do this select Coincident Constraint and select the center of the circle and this line, then select sketch dimension and select this point and this point and enter here 25 millimeters. Okay, and select circle and enter 30 millimeters. Press escape to finish dimensioning and select line drawing and draw the line like this. Okay, escape. And Fusion 360 has automatic constraints enabled by default, and this makes creating geometry much easier in most cases. Then select trim command and trim these edges of the circle and click finish sketch to exit sketch. And now based on this sketch, we will create a solid by rotating the sketch. Select revolve operation. Sketch is selected by default, if not, select the sketch as a profile and then select this line as the rotation axis. Leave other parameters as default and click OK to confirm. And in this way, we created another fragment of the solid using the Revolve operation. And as you can see, in the design of one part, we can use different operations, and the design of one part can be divided into many stages. And just like in the case of extrude operation, in the case of the Revolve operation, we can create a solid based on a 2D sketch, but it can also remove material by rotating the 2D sketch. Let's create another sketch on the construction plane, but as you can see, this plane is invisible, and this plane is located in the construction tab in the feature tree, and you can enable the visibility of this plane by clicking on this symbol. Or you can simply select this plane in the feature tree and then select create sketch. Then draw a circle with a diameter of 5 mm, select the circle drawing command, left click to determine the location of the center of the circle, and now instead of left clicking a second time, press 5 key on the keyboard and press enter. This will create a dimensioned circle, and now I would like to place the center of this circle on the outer edge of this fragment of the solid. But as you can see, when you hover the mouse over this edge doesn't highlight. When you hover over this edge highlights, and we can use this edge for dimensioning or to create some constraints, but when it comes to this edge, we can't use it. But we can use the sketch on the basis of which this fragment of the solid was created, expand the Sketches tab, and enable the visibility of this sketch by clicking this symbol. Then select Coincident Constraint, and select the center of the circle, and select this line, and now the circle is related to this line. Press Escape to cancel this command, and this circle lies on this line. Then select Sketch Dimension, select this line, and select center of the circle, and enter here 8 mm, and OK. Click Finish Sketch to exit the sketch. And what is worth remembering is that if you use a sketch or a reference plane, they will be suppressed, but this doesn't mean that we cannot use them in subsequent operations of creating a 3D solid. Just turn on visibility and we can use these geometries throughout the part design process. Now, based on this sketch, we will create a groove by rotating the sketch, select Revolve operation. Select the profile based on which you want to remove material by rotating the sketch. You can only select half of the circle, but out of habit I indicate the entire sketch, and then select the rotation axis, select this line, and the cut operation is performed by default, but if instead of removing material you would like to add material, you can change this operation to join. I will select cut here and click OK to confirm, and the sketch that we used as a reference to the previous sketch is still visible, and by clicking this symbol you can turn off the visibility of the sketch. And this is where we will end this part of the guide, and in the next part we will discuss the basic operations of solid modification. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to this channel. This supports the growth of this channel.